Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a closer look at the Save dialog. So the Save dialog in Mountain Lion is a little more complex than before. First, you have iCloud options as well as saving a file on your Mac, and you also have a compact version of the Save dialog that appears by default instead of the expanded one. Let's take a look at how to get around in it and make some modifications. So here we are in TextEdit. I've simply created a new document with File New and I've typed some text into it. Now it's time to save it. I'm going to choose File Save or Command S. This is the first time I'm saving it and it's going to ask me where to put it. Now notice a couple things here. First, it's by default saving to iCloud. And second, it's a very compact version of the Save dialog. Let's first change from iCloud to any folder anywhere on my drive and we'll instantly get something that is now saving to the local drive, and you see this expansion button has now appeared and I can expand it to get more of a typical view than you might be used to, where you can navigate around in the Finder and put the file where you want. Incidentally, you can use Command and then the equals key to move back and forth between the two of these. But if you're saving to iCloud, then this is disabled and there is no expansion here. You're just basically saving right to your iCloud folder. You can also have subfolders in your iCloud folder if you created any, and they will appear here as well. Otherwise, it saves it at the top level. Now, we can change this default behavior by using the Terminal app. So run the Terminal app that you have on your Mac, and you need to use this command here. It's a command that will basically, the command is defaults, and then write and change this specific preference to false, which is the document save new documents to cloud. So let's try that. Now once I do that, let me hide the terminal window there. I have to restart TextEdit, and once I do, you can see that if I hit Command S for save, it will default now to saving here. I can still switch back to iCloud. So I still have the option. It's just where you start is different. Now notice that when I do Command S here, I do get this expanded dialog, not the compact one, and it will remember what I did last. So you can see I compacted it and then I canceled and it remembered. So I'll expand it here, hit cancel, and Command S again, and you can see it remembered. Now there is a terminal command for actually saving this so it always starts with the default being to save to the expanded dialog. But of course, since it's not really a problem, because once you change it once, it remembers it the next time. Here is the terminal command, though. If you're curious, you're using the nav panel expanded state for save mode and setting that to true. So you could do that before you ever run TextEdit, and it will start off there instead of in the compact mode. And by the way, the same kind of thing happens with print dialogs. Now you go to File Print, and you get a very compact print dialog here with just a preview and some basics here. If you hit Show Details, it expands to have all the options that you may be used to. And it should remember that. So you can see the next time it automatically went there. There's a terminal command for that as well. If you want to make it the default for all your applications, even before you run them, you can use the printing expanded state for print. Set that to true. And then you'll automatically get the expanded state right away instead of the smaller compact one. So it's in most cases just important to know that you can expand that save dialog, because for a lot of people, if you don't notice that little expand triangle right to the right of the save field, it doesn't seem that you can really have that many options in where to save your file. So it's important to know that and know how to switch between iCloud and on my Mac, and then you've got full functionality and plenty of options. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.